Hello there, YouTube, and welcome along to Steve's first lockdown weekly vlog. I'm literally just getting out of bed. Oh, that's better. I'm out of bed. Hi, everybody. And it is Monday. It's Monday the 29th of June, 2020. I have been awake since 7:30 this morning, but I've been watching some Disney+. I finished watching Wizards of Waverly Place, so I binge-watched that. I'm now on to the next series, which is on my watch list, which is Hannah Montana. I know, guilty pleasure. But, you know, I'm still watching it anyway. It's on my watch list and I'm going to binge that for the next couple of days anyway. Let's have a look very quick and see what is going on outside my window this morning, because I'm just about to open my curtains. Here we go. It's looking a bit windy, a little bit cloudy out there. So, yeah, there's that. I'm just about to get dressed right now as well. Just very quickly, I just wanted to say something very quick. During this week's Lockdown Weekly vlog, you guys can expect me to talk about Hamilton, which is a movie coming out on Disney Plus at the end of the week. I'm also going to be talking sweets as well. Expect to find that very shortly. And I'll be having my first post-lockdown Costa coffee, possibly a Frostino. So, yeah, so a lot's coming up this week, pretty much. So, without further ado, let's start the weekly vlog off by me getting dressed. So my iPad is on 6% battery, so I am now just about to put my iPad on charge. There we go, it's charging now, 6%. There we go, it's on charge. I just want to point something out. I'm wearing a red t-shirt, right? I'm also wearing a red jumper, so it's kind of a red on red day. Okay, I'm now just about to go downstairs and have some breakfast. For breakfast today, I've got some Choco Hoops. I'm just about to go down and eat that right now. So I'm just outside at the moment, taking Buddy for a quick walk around the field. Oh, he's not in my good books today, Buddy. He messed in his crate, which I had to clean up. And this is now the second day in a row that I've had to clean up after his mess, because he seems to think it's okay to go to the toilet in his crate. You know, and to be honest, he's house trained. This is what I don't understand. He's house trained. So I don't, you know, he's a 1 year old dog who is house trained, you know, and he doesn't normally do the toilets in his crate or in the house. He normally does it when we're outside, which is good, or if he's out in the garden, which is good. But yeah. But for the last couple of days, he's just been doing the toilet in his crate, and I don't understand why. So, you know, so I had to tell him off for that. And then when I tried to put his lead on in the back garden, because I put him out in the back garden, it was literally just like a chase around the garden to go and put his lead on. So, oh, he's not in my good books today, Buddy. Unfortunately, you're not, my friend. You are not my friend today, Buddy. Sorry. God. Anyway, I'm also going to be showering Buddy as well. I've been asked to give Buddy a bit of a shower, so I might do some filming of that actually in a few minutes. But yeah, I just thought I'd come on and just say I'm just currently taking Buddy out for a quick walk around the field, and I just wanted to say that he's not in my good books neither, to be honest. Oh, okay, so I am in the bathroom. Buddy is here. And I am just about to take his collar off because I'm going to give him a shower. Hopefully I don't get wet in this, honestly. I just hope that it's just shower, that Buddy just ends up having a shower. And it's not just me as well. Right, you ready for a shower? I don't know. I've got a towel right here. Good boy. You don't like showers, Buddy. No, come here. Come here, good boy. Alright, let's put some shampoo on you. This is shampoo, right? Alright, come here. Put some shampoo. like, why are you doing this to me? You're just getting a bit scruffy, bud, so that's why we need to do this. Okay? That's why we need to do this. Now, we're going to rinse it off. Right? We're going to rinse that off now. Okay? Plus, we want you smelling nice and clean too. Right? Okay, here we go then. Come here. Look, I need to get the shampoo off, bud. Good boy. Oh, buddy, no! Ugh! My trousers are a little bit wet. I'm just currently drying Buddy off. So, ugh. Come here. Oh, I know you're sorry for what you've done. Oh, he's trying to make up to me. Oh. I might have to just give you a bit of a comb over. You know, making sure that you get all this fur nice and straight and nice and clean. Yeah.
Okay, so I have just made myself a Yorkshire tea biscuit brew cup of tea, and I am also going to record some YouTube stuff, which is going up on my YouTube channel tomorrow. It's going to be the Apple announcement video. I've still yet to film that, so I'm going to film that in a moment. But before I do, though, I'm just going to give my friend Bryony a video call at the moment, so I'm just about to do that right now. Okay, so Cadbury is making fudge, chomp and curly whirly chocolate bars under 100 calories. And the reason why they're doing this is because it's a move to help fight childhood obesity. ITV have today confirmed what the first primetime show will be that will be filmed post-pandemic, well, post-lockdown, should I say, because Catchphrase, which is normally hosted by Stephen Mulhern, is set to be returning to ITV this autumn, and new episodes of that will begin filming from Monday the 6th of July. The changes will be made so that the studio set will be set out, so it will allow for the contestants and the presenter and obviously all the other crew members there to be made socially distant, and obviously it will not it'll be filmed without a studio audience as well. It's Monday afternoon and I am currently taking Buddy out for a quick walk on the backfield. Well, I might take him for a long walk actually around the backfield. Gonna have a milk chocolate bar whilst watching Hannah Montana on Disney Plus. Just about to have some lightly salted tortilla chips right now. Look how salted they are. Well, you can't really tell, to be honest, but I'm just about to eat these right now. So it is Monday night and I've had dinner. For dinner tonight I had chicken, roast potatoes, parsnips and mixed veg with gravy. So I technically had a roast for a Monday. This is what I've got for dessert. Look at that. Look at that bad boy, lemon meringue. Okay, look at my chinchilla. Literally, look at what she's standing on her. How is that even comfortable? How is that even comfortable? I have no idea. Oh, good morning everybody, welcome along to Tuesday's part of the lockdown weekly vlog. It's Tuesday morning, I'm currently on my way to work. It's my first day back since my holiday last week, so really looking forward to going back to work actually. Probably why I'm a little bit more lively this morning, because I'm actually looking forward to going back to work. So yeah, I'm just currently on my way to work. Damn, look at that. Oh crap. That's really bad. So I've just got into work and I have got a flask of coffee this morning and I've also got some fruit as well. There we are. Okay, so it's just gone 20 past 11 on this Tuesday morning and I have just got back from work, as you can see. Currently taking Buddy out for a quick walk around the block. Happy 100 days in lockdown, everybody! Yeah! Okay, so There is a song which I've had stuck in my head since this morning when I got into work. So I listened to some music before I got into work this morning. There's a song by Jason Derulo called Savage Love, right? And it's a song which the instrumental for it is on TikTok, and it's doing the rounds on TikTok as well. I've seen some videos on TikTok of people dancing to the chorus of that song, right? And I'm now going to attempt doing it. I'm going to record it on my phone, but I need like the dance routine to be up on my iPad at the same time, because I kind of get a little bit confused. So yeah, I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to upload it to TikTok. If you're not yet following me on TikTok, I haven't posted anything on there in a year up until now, when you guys watch this. So follow me on TikTok. I might do more TikToks, I don't know. But follow me on TikTok, it's SteveOfficial2019. Okay, I tell you what, let's do it. Let's do the TikTok one, shall we? The TikTok version. It's coming up, okay? It's coming up. That's gonna be my new addicted song, I think. So over the last couple of weeks, it was announced that Cineworld was planning to reopen its doors here in the UK to the members of the public from July 10th. That doesn't seem to be the case anymore, because they have today posted an update on their Twitter page. At Cineworld is their Twitter page if you want to give them a follow. And this is the update. So, update: in line with recent changes to upcoming film release dates, we are moving our reopening date to July 31st. Currently in the middle of exporting my YouTube video, which is going up in a second on my YouTube channel, Steve Official, which is Steve's Let's Talk Apple WWDC 2020 announcements. And boom, there we are, look, Steve's Let's Talk Apple WWDC 2020 announcements is available to watch on my YouTube channel, Steve Official.
Just made myself a Yorkshire tea biscuit brew on this Tuesday night. Just about to set my alarms on my phone for tomorrow morning. So there's one, there's two, and there's three. There we are, 4:55, 4:57, and 4:59, as I've got to be awake early tomorrow for work.
Just about to have a video call with my friend Zoe on Instagram for 10 or 15 minutes. Oh, this is her now. Hello and good morning. It is Wednesday morning. It's just coming up to around about 20 past 11 at the time of recording this part of the weekly vlog. It is Wednesday, it's halfway through the week, which means we're halfway through the lockdown, the first lockdown weekly vlog on this YouTube channel. So, I am just about to put Disney Plus on, because I want to watch, I want to carry on binging on Hannah Montana. I know, guilty pleasure. McDonald's have just announced what's going to be returning to their menu from Wednesday the 8th of July, and this is the following things that will be returning to their menu from Wednesday the 8th of July. So they've got milkshakes, they are going to be back on the menu. Mayo chicken, bacon mayo chicken, hot chocolate, bacon double cheeseburger, and Happy Meal organic milk. So this is what they've said as well. As we continue to adapt to the social distancing and safety measures in our kitchens and service areas, we will constantly review what we're able to sell and hope to reintroduce more items later in the summer. That is a little statement from McDonald's. So yeah, so you know, if you're after a milkshake, you know, you'll be able to get one from McDonald's from the 8th of July. Happy Canada Day! It is the 1st of July, and of course, today is not only the start of a new month, but it is also Canada Day. So happy Canada Day to all the Canadians out there that could potentially, or potentially not, be watching this YouTube video. Who knows? Just had a Facebook video call with my friend, Bryony. Okay, so I want to talk about a local business here in Dorset. And first of all, can I just say a big thank you to Brogan Tate, who is a YouTuber. And also an Instagrammer as well. She kind of introduced me to these guys through her Instagram story. Because about a week or two ago, she got given a gift by these guys, which I'm going to talk about right now. It's a little local business that's here in Dorset, but you can order what I'm about to tell you nationwide across the UK. Okay, so this is their Instagram page. It's called The Bon Bon Boys. What a name to have, eh? The Bon Bon Boys. That sounds like a boy band, you know, with a very, I don't know, very sweet tasting sound boy band, you know. But this is, so they're a candy store, as you can tell. And they do delicious pick a mix. They ship all over the UK. There's free delivery to most BH postcodes. That's people that lives in Bournemouth area, roundabout. And they're based in Dorset. And they've also got a website which they've linked on their page, which is bonbonboys.com. I'll just show you some of their Instagram content that they've got. Look at this. I mean, you know, this is why I love following these guys on Instagram, because they just grace my Insta feed with photos of sweets. I mean, look at this. So nice. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I am going to click on their link. Can we do this? Can we access it? Please say we can. Here we go. So this is their website, and this is the, basically, you get a 9-inch pizza box lookalike, and they just fill it with sweets, with pick-a-mix sweets. Okay, and it's pick a mix to your door. A box bursting at the seams with sugary goodness, easing the lockdown blues. So you can follow them on Instagram, or you can find them on Facebook as well. And they've also got a little what's hot this week. And they've got mermaids, bananas, watermelons, necklaces. And this is what they have. So they have over 50 varieties of lip-smackingly good pick-a-mix ready to be delivered to your direct to your door. We list all of our sweets, past and present, and we're super transparent about all of our ingredients and allergies as well. So there we go. And there they are, look, holding up the boxes of goodness. And then there's a little bit of about who they are and stuff like that. So it's worth a read. Now, if I press on, get your box now, right, you can shop. So you can go for the classic one, or you can go for the vegan one. Now, obviously, the vegan one is full of vegan sweets. They are both £10.95. So if you press on that one, there. And then obviously, look, those are the kinds of sweets that you'll get in the box. That's for the classic one. So, and obviously they've got all the ingredients as well, on here as well. They'll tell you about the ingredients. You can also put, a sweet message to put a smile on your recipient's face as well. And then all you just basically do is just put add to basket. And then you got one item in your cart, and it's that one. So all you got to do then is just update your, you just got to do the calculate shipping. I don't know if it's actually going to work, to be honest. There we go. Just currently on the backfield, taking Buddy for a quick walk around the backfield. There he is, look. There's Buddy. Buddy. Hello, hello, bud. Oh, he's so cute, isn't he? Yes, he is, anyway. So, yeah, I'm just currently taking Buddy out for a quick walk, just on the back field. Good morning. It's Thursday morning, and I have just got out of bed. The time is just 9:10 right now. I've been awake since around about 7:30 this morning, but I've spent the last sort of hour and a half just checking social media. I've also been watching some videos on TikTok as well, so... Yeah, that's right. I'm kind of bringing that addiction back again of being on TikTok and watching videos of people dancing and doing really funny content on TikTok and stuff like that. So there we go. Anyway, it is Thursday morning, like I say, and I'm just about to start the day by getting dressed.
Okay, let's see what the weather's doing outside this morning. Oh, it's looking not too bad. Blue sky, bit of a wind as well.
Currently taking Buddy out for a quick walk around the backfield.
Buddy! Yeah? Buddy! Hello! Oh, there he goes.
Today is the 2nd of July 2020, and today is World UFO Day. Have you seen a UFO? I'm just checking outside to see if there's any out. No, there's no UFOs out there. Anyway, happy World UFO Day, guys. Okay, so it is Thursday night, and I've just got something to tell you very quick. Because I was looking at TikTok earlier, and I saw a little video which Well, I basically did what this video told me to do, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to be kind, I'm going to be generous, I'm going to technically show you guys how you can watch movies and stuff on your iPhone and your iPad. So from what I know, you can only do this via iOS, from what I know. I don't know if you can do it on Android or not, but what you need to do is you need to go onto the App Store on your iOS device, whether it's an iPad or an iPhone, and then you just need to type in the search tab on the App Store, you just need to type in the word watched, and it'll be that one on the top there. The top one is the one you need, so just press watched. And then what you need to do is you need to go on the first one you see, which is this one here. It's called Watched Multimedia Browser. And then obviously I've already downloaded it for my iPhone, so I'm just going to press the cloud button so it can download onto my iPad. So I'm just going to wait for that now to download. Okay, so once it's done downloading, all you just need to do then is you just need to press the open button. Okay, once you've opened it, all you need to do then is you need to press onto, so set up watch, install a bundle first, click on manager on the side menu. So all you need to do is go on the side here and you just need to press manager and then you just enter a URL. Now I'm going to enter this one and this is the one that I've been using and you guys can use it too. So it's whoho.to, so it's whoho.to, press the enter. And then this is what will come up. Boom. All of this stuff here. So you have got things like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. You've also got Flash. You've got Law and Order. You've got Dark. You've got The Simpsons. And I'll tell you what, speaking of The Simpsons, let's go on there. So this is obviously The Simpsons. You've got from Season 1. And it actually, oh, there we go. And then if I scroll down, look, I can go all the way down to Season 31. Look, there's season 31. I'm just going to press season 31. I'm just going to press done. And then I'm just going to go to the first episode. And then obviously you're going to get this list of servers. I choose the top one, the first one, which is server 2. Just press play. And then look, there we are. I've got The Simpsons on my iPad. This is from season 31. How awesome is this? So there we go. So that is how to get free TV shows and also free movies as well, because there are movies on that app as well if you do that. So that's how to get that onto your iPhone and iPad. Good morning and welcome to Friday's part of the first lockdown weekly vlog here on my YouTube channel. It is Friday morning, it's around about 5:15 at the time of recording this part of the weekly vlog, and I'm currently on my way to work this morning, which is something that I don't normally do on a Friday morning. Normally around about this time of the morning I'd still be in bed asleep. Just got into work and I'm just about to have a flask of coffee and I'm also going to listen to some music as well, my Bluetooth headphones. I've just finished work and I've decided to treat myself to a Costa Belgian chocolate frostino. Yum. So I had that Costa, by the way, I had a Belgian chocolate frostino from my Costa visit, my first Costa visit. I'm going to take this thing off. Yeah, I had that and it was quite nice actually. I did miss Costa, not going to lie, during the lockdown. Anyway, I'm just currently walking back to my house. Just got off the bus. So yeah, anyway, it's Friday afternoon. just come back outside to take Buddy here for a walk along the backfield. So, today is Friday the 3rd of July, and it's a good day to have Disney Plus, because on Disney Plus today, you have got brand new episodes of It's a Dog's Life with Bill Farmer. You've also got Frozen 2, which is on Disney Plus. And it's also on Sky Cinema as well today. Plus, you have also got Hamilton. Yeah, Hamilton. And as a matter of fact, right now, I am going to be watching that movie, Hamilton, right now on Disney Plus. I'll give you my thoughts on it very shortly, and what I'm also going to be doing over on Twitter is I'm going to be doing a tweet along as well. So I'm going to chat with my Twitter fans over on Twitter about the movie Hamilton, which I'm now looking forward to watching. I've actually added Hamilton to my watch list. So here it is. Look, there we are. Look, there's Hamilton. So without further ado, I'm going to hit play. I'm going to turn my TV up a little bit, because it's not that loud. There we are. And yeah, I'm now just about to watch Hamilton. Here we go. Rise up. Anyway, hi. I've just finished watching that film, Hamilton, on Disney Plus. Oh my God. I absolutely loved it. You know, I loved it to the point where I actually have just downloaded the soundtrack on Apple Music, so I can go back and listen to it again. Because honestly, you know, I'm not one to watch musicals. Okay, I'm not one to watch musicals. I remember seeing the film Cats last year in the cinema, and to be honest, that film was so bad, you know. But it was a musical anyway, but I didn't really like it that much. But this one, oh my God. You know, this is why we need to save the arts industry, honestly, because of shows like that that are on Disney Plus, you know? And from what I know as well, that show is also supposed to be hitting the West End, but not anytime soon, obviously. But that film was amazing. You know, 2 hours and 40 minutes long, but that film was so incredible and powerful in so many places. You know, some of the lyrics in that as well are very strong as well. So anyway, Hamilton is available to watch right now on Disney Plus around the world. Go and give it a watch at some point this week, because it is such an amazing film. I cannot stress how good it is. And this is coming from a guy who never sits down and watches musicals ever, you know? So please do give this a watch, because it is a truly beautiful masterpiece. That's all I'm gonna say about Hamilton for now.
We will currently watching Boris Johnson's coronavirus press briefing via Sky News on Facebook.
Retail and hospitality nationwide, we will only shut establishments locally.
Okay, I'm currently listening to a song that I've just recorded on this app called Smule, and it sounds so good. It sounds so good. Anyway, I'm going to talk to you guys about Smule next week on my lockdown weekly vlog number 2, but honestly, I'm loving what I'm hearing. Okay, I may have spent most of the evening on that app, Smule, and I've been recording videos and some audio of me singing some various songs, and they vary from like Adamant, Duran Duran, Take That, Nothing But Thieves, Harry Styles, Robbie Williams, you know, Elvis Presley is another one as well, and yeah. So I've been spending most of the evening doing that. But anyway, like I say, I'll talk to you guys about Smule next week. I'll give you my username if you want to add me up on Smule if you have it. then I'll give you my username in next week's vlog, don't worry. Anyway, it is now Friday night and it's just gone 10:30. I've just got my work uniform ready for tomorrow because I am working tomorrow once again, which I don't mind anyway. I mean, it's my day to be working anyway. So I'm now just about to get myself ready to get into bed and head off to sleep. So I will probably speak to you guys once I get home from work tomorrow, I think. Yeah, I think I will. Anyway, so I will end this part of the vlog here and I will speak to you guys in the morning. See you then. Hello everybody and happy 4th of July. It is the 4th of July today. So happy Independence Day to the Americans potentially watching this lockdown weekly vlog. I was just reading an article by the Daily Mirror via Facebook because it's been announced that 3 new Cadbury Dairy Milk chocolate bars will be going on sale in Tesco supermarkets from Wednesday, July the 8th. So when you guys watch this, it'll be from Wednesday, July 8th. So maybe later this week, or it'll be on sale now if you're watching it after July 8th. but yeah, so they will be on sale at Tesco supermarkets from Wednesday, July 8th. And then it'll be launching in participating supermarkets nationwide on July 22nd. So let's take a look and see what these 3 new Cadbury Dairy Milk chocolate bars are. So we're going to start with this one. So this one's Jillian's Cadbury Dairy Milk Cocoa Nutty. So this is a combination of milk chocolate with coconut crumble, studded with smooth white crisp pearls. And this was created by Jillian, 36, from Northern Ireland, whose bar is inspired by her children's love of fresh coconut. The next one, you've got Shannon's Cadbury Dairy Milk Crunchy Honeycomb. So with this one, it's a blended milk chocolate with golden crunchy honeycomb pieces, tasty caramel flavoured fudge and chopped hazelnuts for added crunch. So this was created by Shannon, a 19-year-old student from Nottingham, who combined her 2 favourite flavours for this sweet treat. Finally, you've got Taylor's Cadbury Dairy Milk Out of the Blueberry. So Taylor, a 24-year-old mother of 2 children from Leeds, says she created Out of the Blueberry because of her son's love and obsession for blueberries. So her chocolate bar consists of milk chocolate with juicy blueberry-flavoured nuggets and white crisp pearls. So those are the 3 new Cadbury Dairy Milk chocolate bars that are launching in Tesco supermarkets from July 8th and in other participating supermarkets nationwide from July 22nd. So the reason why this is happening is because they're limited edition and they're for a limited time only. So obviously the reason why is because members of the public have until September 6th to vote for their favourite new chocolate bar, which is the 3 that I've just spoken about, which will stay on sale. And you can vote online at CadburyInventor.com. So there we go. The 3 105-gram bars will set you back £1.49. But the prices can differ from store to store, okay, but they do start from around about £1.49. So you know what I'm thinking in next week's weekly vlog, as they are being released next week at the time of recording this vlog, I might actually buy all 3 and I might do my taste testing and I'll let you guys know my thoughts of all 3 chocolate bars. I think that'll be nice. And I'll let you know what one I think should win. I think I've done this before on my YouTube channel. I'm pretty certain I have. I've done it before. But I think it'll be nice to do that again, you know, during this weekly vlog, during the lockdown weekly vlog. So be sure to check that out next week during the weekly vlog. I might do that. Currently watching Nick Tatum on Facebook as he's doing a Facebook Live.
Unemployment, folks stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So be the best of these tests and don't ask why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time.
Facebook, I met you on Facebook, 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 baby. Met you Facebook, Facebook, Facebook.
Managers on the floor because I dropped
wine. Oh, God. I love this song by Nick Tatum, the Facebook song.
Stranger sitting in a picture of one of the things. I bet he thinks she's pretty, but now I don't know. There is no
hanging around. I met you on Facebook. My friend, you were pretty. Facebook, Facebook, Facebook. I met you on Facebook, 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 baby. Met you Facebook, 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 Facebook. Woo! I love this song. So it is Saturday night. I have just uploaded my UK Top 40 Official Charts episode 14 video on my YouTube channel, SteveOfficial, so that's available for you guys to watch after the lockdown weekly vlog video has finished. So I'm currently watching my next binge on Disney Plus after watching The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. This is The Sweet Life on Deck on Disney Plus. I'm binge watching that at the moment, and I have just gone downstairs, by the way, and made myself this lovely looking hot chocolate, this galaxy hot chocolate right there. So I'm just going to stand you guys up here for a second, hopefully that focuses, there we go, because I'm gonna give you guys my reaction, my thoughts on this galaxy hot chocolate. So without further ado, let me give this a try. Damn. That is good hot chocolate, I'm not gonna lie. I tell you what, if that's the case, I'm gonna be having that hot chocolate every night for at least the next few weeks whilst that hot chocolate in there lasts me. Damn, that is good. I'm just gonna have one more. Yeah, that is the one. That is the one, guys. Oh, okay, what's the time? Blimey, it's 11:30. Anyway, it is 11:30 and I have just got home after going out for half an hour. I had to go out and run, I had to do an errand very quick. Which, yeah, I should have been in bed about half an hour ago. So I am now just about to get myself ready. Well, I'm in my pyjamas, I'm back in my pyjamas again. I had to get my clothes back on to go out. And yeah, so I'm now back home in my pyjamas and I'm just about to head off to bed. Oh, good morning, this is. Good morning. It is Sunday morning and I am currently walking to work. It's around about 20 past 5 at the time of recording this part of the vlog. I'm really tired today. Honestly, me going to bed last night at 12:45 really didn't help, but, you know, never mind, I guess. Just got into work, and for breakfast today I've got a flask of coffee, and I'm also going to have a deli meat feast. Okay, it is Sunday afternoon, and I have just got home from work. Watching The Suite Life on Deck on Disney Plus. Okay, I want to talk about cinemas, because the cinemas have reopened now. Well, Odeon Cinema has reopened now. And this is for today. This is Sunday's viewings, okay, in Odeon. So you've got 1917, Bad Boys for Life, Blackwater Abyss, Bloodshot, Dark Waters, Harley Quinn, Birds of Prey, Jumanji, The Next Level, Just Mercy, Little Women, Misbehavior, My Spy, Onward, St. Francis. You've also got Sonic the Hedgehog, The Call of the Wild, The Dark Knight, The Greatest Showman, and The Hangover. Okay, so I'm going to go back to the top of the list, and this is the 1917. This is showing today at 7:30, right? Now, I don't know how well this is going to come up on screen. Here we go. This is the seating arrangements for 1917, the movie. Look at that. Nobody is sitting in any of those seats for that screening. Okay? And it's the same. It is the same for Bad Boys for Life. This is the 3:15 showing of Bad Boys for Life. Okay. There's two people. There's two people sitting in the disabled for the 3:15 showing, which is in the recliner screen. That's the recliner screen. And I will show you the showing that's on at 8:00 tonight for Bad Boys for Life. Once again, look, this is at 8:00 tonight. Nobody is sitting in the seats, in any of those seats for that screening. And I will show you, let's move on to the next one, Blackwater Abyss, which is on tonight at 8:40. And again, look, no one is sitting in those seats for that screening. So there's one showing of that tonight. There's Bloodshot, and that we've got showings from 3:00 this afternoon. Again, no one is sitting in them seats. You've also got a showing at 6:00 this evening. And again, no one is sitting in them seats. You know. And you've got one showing tonight at 9:15 for Bloodshot. Which is, again, same story. No one is sitting in them seats, you know. We've got Dark Waters, which is on at 6:45 in the recliner screen this evening. No one is sitting in the recliner screen. Look. No one's sitting in them. And then you've also got Harley Quinn Birds of Prey, which is showing tonight at 7:45. And again, no one is sitting in them seats for that. So there's one showing of that. You got Jumanji The Next Level, which is on at 2:15. And it's subtitled for people hard of hearing. So, and again, no one's sitting in that Jumanji The Next Level movie. You got Just Mercy, which is on tonight at 6:30. And again, where it wants to, there we are. Again, no one's sitting in those seats. You know, you got Little Women, which is in a recliner screen at 2:15 this afternoon. And again, no one's sitting in them seats. You got Misbehavior, which again's in a recliner screen, and that's on at 6:15 tonight. And again, no one's sitting in that screening at all. You got My Spy, which is on at 4:45. And again, no one is sitting in those seats when it, there we are. No one's sitting in those seats. Yeah. You've also got, what else have we got? We've got Onward.
Now, onwards on in the iSense screen, which is the biggest room in the cinema with the really loud speakers, you know. So, we got a 1:30 showing in the iSense screening, which, again, hopefully, there we go. Again, look, no one's sitting in them seats. And then you've got a screening at 4:30 in that same screen. And again, I'll show you. There we go. Yep. No one's sitting in them seats. And then you've also got screenings at 2:30. And again, I mean, yep. Look, no one's sitting in them seats. And you got a screening at 3:30. Which again, look. When it comes up. No one's sitting in them seats. 5:30 for onwards. Again. No one's sitting in them seats. And then you've got St. Francis at 8:15. Yeah, let's have a look at that. No one's sitting in them, neither. Look, no one's sitting in them seats. It's awful, isn't it? And then Sonic the Hedgehog, we've got a showing at 1 o'clock. So look, this is Sonic the Hedgehog at 1 o'clock. Not good. You know, no one's sitting in there. That movie is supposed to be starting at the time recording this in 15 minutes time. And there's no one sitting in that screening at all. Then you've got a showing at 2 o'clock for Sonic the Hedgehog. And again, no one's sitting in that. And then you've got another screening at 4 o'clock. And again, no one is sitting in that. Look, there we are. No one's sitting there. And then you've got one final screening for Sonic the Hedgehog at 5 o'clock today. And let's have a look at the seating. You know, look, again, no one is sitting in those seats. And then, what else have we got? Got Call of the Wild, which is on at 1:15. So at the time of recording this, in around about half an hour's time, this is showing. Is anyone sitting in these seats? Nope. It's exactly the same. It's exactly the same. And then you've got The Dark Knight tonight, which is the Batman. So some of these are the older films now that are getting re-released. So this is showing at 7 o'clock tonight. Look. No one is sitting in those seats. And then you've got The Greatest Showman, which you'd think people will be going to the cinema to go and watch. You know, given how popular that film is. This is at 5:15, is it 5:15? Yeah, 5:15 today. Look, no one is sitting in that screening at all for The Greatest Showman, the most popular film out there. And finally, The Hangover, which is in a recliner screen at 9 o'clock tonight. Look at this. Yep, again, no one is sitting in that screening. So, two things we can learn from this. One, that's not good for Odeon, you know, given that they've just reopened yesterday. And two, you know, I mean, people, I guess in a way, people are scared of going to the cinema because you are sitting in an enclosed space for, you know, an hour and a half or just over 2 hours, you know, depending what film you're seeing. But, you know, I mean, to be honest, I'm looking forward to going back to the cinema. I can confirm that I'm actually going to go back to the cinema on Friday next week. So I'm going to go and watch the movie Onward in cinemas because I never got the chance to go and see that movie before lockdown started. So I'm going to go and watch that movie in the cinema on Friday next week. And I will let you guys know what I think of that movie once I've been to see it. I know it's out on DVD, you know, it's not on Disney Plus, you know,
I'm probably going to have to wait a further few more months before it comes to Disney Plus. But if it's out in the cinema, you know, I would love to go back to the cinema and, you know, have that experience of sitting in one of those seats with loudspeakers and a big screen in front of me. Of course I would, you know. And obviously, you know, I will, you know, if there are people in the cinema, I will obviously keep my distance from them. And obviously the people who work at the cinema will make sure that I am socially distant from anyone else that's going to see that movie. You know, because obviously all the other customers will have to pick seats that are 2 meters away from me or possibly even more than that. So, you know, so there is that anyway. Yeah. So I'm looking forward to going back to the cinema next week. Yeah, anyway, I just thought I'd let you guys know what the cinema screenings were looking like, you know. And I guess in a way it's not looking good for Odeon because they're not getting money coming in, you know. And I'm also surprised because if you're a Limitless member, you kind of get to go to the cinema for free between now and your next pay in August. Well, your next, you know, when your next payment comes out in August. So, you know, I'm really surprised about that. Anyway, I'm going to shut up now because my battery's about to die on my camera. But I just thought I'd tell you about Odeon Cinemas. So, it is Sunday evening. I have just had my dinner and I've also just cleaned my chinchilla cage out as well. Okay, it's Sunday night. I have literally just had a 2-hour and 55-minute video call with my friend Kieran on Skype, which I normally have on a Sunday. You know, we normally have a video call on a Sunday and a Wednesday. We've been doing that since the start of lockdown anyway. I'm just about to get my shoes on, take Buddy out for a quick walk, and then I'm going to come back. I'm going to have another one of those Galaxy hot chocolates, I think, that I had last night, because it was that good. I'm going to have another one tonight, which I'm really looking forward to. And then I'm going to get myself into my pyjamas and get myself ready for bed. So I'm going to end the weekly vlog here. Thank you for watching the first lockdown weekly vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you're not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe. Obviously, the subscribe button is down below. And don't forget to hit the bell button as well. Because if you hit the bell button, then you will get notified as to when I release videos on my YouTube channel via your smartphone and tablet, etc., etc. So please hit that bell button down below as well as soon as you subscribe. Join me next week when I will be doing some dairy milk tasters. I will also be giving you all the details on Smule, and I'll show you some of the songs that I'm very proud of as well. I'll play some of those for you, and I will also be talking about a new song that I've recently discovered called Banana by Shaggy. I'll tell you about that. And I've also got the day out in Bournemouth where I go to Bournemouth Beach. I go to the cinema. I have my first post-lockdown KFC. And also my first post-lockdown Wetherspoons as well. And I will tell you all the details you need to know about going into your local Wetherspoons pub as well. Tell you all about that. So that's all from me. Thank you for watching. And I will see you guys in the next YouTube video, which will be released tomorrow, the 7th of July, at the time of filming this. That'll be released, yeah, tomorrow, the 7th of July, which will be my Call of Duty mobile gaming video. But anyway, from me, it's goodbye. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.